Welcome to September Drill. I'm General Slocum, and this is what I know today. I know that last month we had an absolutely amazing open house and air show. It's estimated that there were 235,000 people here at Selfridge, and a further 100,000 people out on the lake and the marinas and on the rivers watching the air show, not to mention well over 1 million watching on the live stream TV. More to follow on that later on. But what a tremendous success. Heard nothing but great accolades. The community had a great time. Our folks, amazing work, stepping up, making it all happen. We're here today in front of Building 304, the headquarters of our mission support group, because a lot of what made this happen are those folks that keep this base running on a day-to-day basis. I mean, all statuses, from our state employees to our Title V civilians, AGRs, technicians, everybody pitched in to be able to make this happen in a big way. What a great success, and thank you to everyone. I am standing here today with Master Sergeant Chris Tarquino. I just really wanted to highlight some of the fantastic work Chris has done, and related to the air show in some ways, because he's done a lot of work in emergency management, getting this Web Cobra program up and running, which is known as a common operating picture. And the whole idea is to exchange information and to give situational awareness and educate everybody whenever there's a contingency event. So in our command post and our EOC, this is how we exchange information and keep everybody where they need to be so that we can make good decisions. I tell you what, with everything going on, it's been tough. He's been doing the Web Cobra training. People have had a lot of other things to do. He's had to be flexible. He has been a role model of communicating, collaborating, and making things happen. So I want to start off this drill video just by a coin, my commander's coin, saying thank you so much for just exemplifying all the great work that came together to make things like our air show happen. So Chris, congratulations. Glad you're part of the team. Job well done.
Thank you, sir.
You bet. Thanks. Well, like I said, there was a lot going on with this air show. Tons of different things that are happening. It's also the 70th anniversary of the United States Air Force. If you think of this history, one, this base goes back 100 years, but the United States Air Force at 70 years old, 1947, being established as a separate service, a distinct service of our United States military. So we've been a part of aviation history here at Selfridge well before the founding of the US Air Force, but now we're also having this opportunity to see where we've come in the 70 years. There's a lot that's happened. And Selfridge and the 127th Wing has been a big part of that. There's a lot of things that are going on as we lead into this drill weekend. We have September 11th, Patriots Day. Can't forget, I remember exactly where I was when I saw what happened at the Twin Towers. It was very impactful. It changed our nation, it changed our military, and it changed our posture, a significant impact on the Air National Guard. It changed Selfridge. So we need to keep our eye on the ball and just remember that there is evil in the world. There's a reason that we do what we do with our warfighting mission, so that we stand ready to do what we need to do when we need to do it. So thank you once again for your effort in readiness and keeping us ready to go. It's important. Friday the 15th of September is also POW MIA Day. That's Prisoners of War and Missing in Action. So we're going to take time to have a remembrance. There's going to be lots of ceremonies that are going on that are going to look at those that have been prisoners of war and those that are still missing in action from our wars and campaigns around the world. It's a big impact on the families, it's a big impact on the communities, and we have a lot of local heroes right here in our community that have been prisoners of war. So let's just take a little bit of time as we head into this drill weekend and recognize those that do serve our nation, those that have served our nation, and the families of those that are still paying those prices. As we head into this drill weekend, we've had two hurricanes. One, Hurricane Harvey in the Texas area, and now we're waiting to see what's going to happen with Hurricane Irma. The National Guard has stepped up in a big way. It's what we're supposed to do. It's one of our three primary missions with domestic response. I've communicated clearly that the 127th Wing and the Selfridge facility stand ready to help, but the Air National Guard has shown what our mettle really is all about in this particular case when it comes to domestic operations. So those that have participated, and if we do more in the near future, thank you. We stand ready to support the victims of these hurricanes. I'd also like to take some time to talk with you about the Chief of Staff of the Air Force's initiative to revitalize the squadrons. And it seems kind of like a platitude statement, but the squadrons really are the lifeblood of our organization. If you think about it, that's the level of organization where we really function, and that's where we win or lose when it comes to getting something done. So we're going to spend some time focusing on the squadrons, and here in the near future, I'm going to come out and I'm going to talk to each of the squadrons because I'd like to talk about this initiative a little bit with you, but also get some feedback from you on things that we can do. My goal is to make sure that we have commanders, chiefs, and senior enlisted in all of these organizations that feel empowered to be able to make the tough decisions, to make the right calls, to accept the risk, to be able to set our organizations on the proper path. But I also want to make sure that everybody in our squadrons is empowered to know that they have a voice. If something's broken, you tell us it's broken, but more importantly, you tell us how to fix it. That's what we want to do in our organization. We want to make sure that we're pushing that out, empowering our commanders, empowering our people, so that we can have squadrons that are able to get the job done when they get the call. Now, and I'm going to throw it over to our wonderful command chief. Chief, what have you got for us this month?
Thank you, General Slocum and team. Welcome to September's RSD. Guess what? This is an amazing backdrop, and it is a reflection of the amazing men and women we have here at Selfridge Air National Guard Base who did an amazing job. F-35, 100-year celebration, and of course the air show, probably the best scene to date. So thank you very much for all that you've done. And now, as we roll into this month, the first thing I want to say is our thoughts and prayers go out to our airmen in Texas and in Florida. You know, we do have wingmen down there that are really going through it right now, so let's really think about them. As well, we've got some wingmen here to include myself who have family members down in Texas and in Florida, so let's look out for them and make sure that they're doing okay. And what that does is that rolls right into the fact that the boss and I have talked about leadership out front. You know, not behind your desk, but out front, making sure we spend quality time with our airmen. You know, this is Suicide Prevention Month, and we want to make sure that we are taking care of our airmen as best as we possibly can. And that is because leaders get out from behind their desks, they'll get away from their computers, they'll get away from whatever's a distraction from spending some quality time with their men and women to make sure they're doing okay. Rolling right into the fact that it is the Outstanding Airman of the Year season. So let's start thinking about all these great things that our great airmen have done over this year. So our Outstanding Airman of the Year for 2017 will be recognized properly. And then of course, the blended retirement system, that's coming up, and we need to make sure that we have some informed airmen about what's going to happen with their future. So over in Building 168, there are going to be four separate briefings that we're going to be able to have, two on Saturday and two on Sunday. Please don't miss it. And then of course, happy birthday, Air Force, 70 years young. We are the youngest of the services, but we are innovative and we do some of the best work that we've ever seen, not just in the Air National Guard, but in the Air Force as a whole. And we are the best Air Force on the planet. So again, happy 70th birthday. Now team, I hate that I'm not gonna see you on Saturday because I have to go to Battle Creek to take care of a little business with the State Command Chief, but I will definitely be here on Sunday for all of the things that'll be going on then. So we got a lot that's going to be happening, but again, let's get out and let's spend some quality time with our airmen. Let's remember our airmen that are down there in Texas and in Florida. And oh, by the way, for the five airmen that came home from the air refueling group last weekend, welcome back home to your team and to your families. Now back to you, General Slocum.
Thanks, Chief. Appreciate it a lot. Well, we're about to wrap up, but I always like to finish foot stomping, talking about safety. You know, there's a lot going on. We've been remarkable when it comes to doing the right things, but I'm asking that we continue to stay vigilant so that we can maintain this record of excellence that we've had for a long time. So do good risk management. Make sure that if we're doing something new, if it's dumb, dangerous, or different, doesn't mean we can't do it. It just means we raise that level of acceptance and make sure that the right person is the one accepting that risk. So let us help you when it comes to doing things smart around here. And remember, everyone owns a knock it off, which means that you can stop any process that's going on and just take a deep breath and say, let's just hold on a minute and figure out if there's a smarter way to do what we're doing. You have my word on that one. You're empowered with that knock it off every day. And to finish up this video today, I'd like to say just congratulations to the 127th Operations Group that's receiving the Winston P. Wilson Trophy from Naugus for being the most outstanding fighter organization in the Air National Guard. We have to realize that this award goes way beyond our operations group, obviously hand in hand with the maintenance group and the fantastic work that goes on there. But none of this happens without the support of everybody on this base to make it happen. So once again, this Winston P. Wilson Trophy is just an accolade to the excellence here in the 127th Wing and of Selfridge Air National Guard Base. The awards keep rolling in, and it's because you're so awesome. I'm General Slocum. This is what I know today.